Hey everyone, welcome back to It's Still Really Cold in This Room and I Can't Feel My Toes. And by that I mean Risk of Rain. Last time, Plays the Bandit tried to, well, made a valiant attempt, I suppose, at unlocking the last artifact. This one right here. Can't even remember which one that is. Is it Spite? No, it's not Spite. Shoot, which one was that? Hold on. Honor, Kin, Distortion, Spite, Glass, Enigma, Command, Spirit. That's Origin here. What was this one? Oh, gosh. I can't actually remember, which is annoying me. Well, anyway, that was my goal. I did not succeed, which is fine. I mean, that run, I just kind of doomed myself by just taking way too freaking long. So this time, I want to do the... I'm not going to do the same thing. No, I'm going to... play as Acrid. Yeah, I'm gonna do a nice, calm Acrid run. And I'm gonna do this with Glass and Command and Kin. Actually, no. Just Glass and Kin. Yeah, just Glass and Kin. That's it. That's all I want. So, I'm only gonna have one type of enemy per stage, and I'm going to have 10% of my health but do 500% of my damage. It's gonna be nice. I'm gonna die. That's just kind of inevitable. I'm gonna die. But I'm gonna try my hardest. Really, the only reason I'm bothering to play as Acrid right now is because I want to get back into the swing of this game. It has been a while, and I've gotten rusty. I don't necessarily like that. I don't like being rusty at this game. This is such a good game. For a while, it was my primary series, so I kind of have to be at least decent at it. So yeah. Question then becomes, do I want to farm for a bit, or do I want to go straight for the teleporter? I'm actually thinking I should go straight for the teleporter, but I'm insane. So, not gonna. And that's gonna die. So yeah, you can see how quickly I'm annihilating all these enemies, golems and stuff. That's the power of Glass. Actually, oh gosh, all this loot that I don't think I'm going to be able to get, this makes me sad. Those things are all going to die. Yeah. Nice, Guardian's Heart. It's actually pretty useful when I only have 30 max health right now. Okay. I guess I'll just go to the teleporter. I'm going to kill everything I encounter on the way, because that money is going to be valuable. To say the least. That was the sound of a golem spawning. I'm actually really wishing this weren't monsoon difficulty, because if it weren't, I could actually afford to spend some extra time and kill stuff. I am actually recording this episode immediately after the last one, so if my voice still sounds a little bit icky, I apologize, that's kind of what happens. Alright, Explorer's Key. Explorer's Key? Explorer's Key. How am I going to use this thing? So this thing opens every chest within a visible area, and a little bit outside that as well. I think... I'm not sure what I want to do with it. Do I want to go back for the big chest or open those two smaller chests? Decisions, decisions. Well, I think if I use it... Oh, hold on. You are right in my way. I think if I use it right about here, I should get the small chest below me as well. So that was probably worth it, I think. Things didn't get hit that weren't on the caustic sludge. Alright, I would rather have the Explorer's Key than Disposable Missile Launcher, even though Disposable Missile Launcher is certainly very good. And Head Stompers, okay. That's fine. Falling on enemies does a bunch of damage. Not as much as I'd like, but, you know, it's enough to justify it. I'm gonna get increased crit chance here. Or rather, chance to do double damage, which is functionally a critical hit. And I could go back for that big chest, but at the same time, the longer I linger, the more dead I'm gonna be later, so probably shouldn't linger very long. All these golems proving to be not a problem. Or I guess it would be probably more grammatically correct to say proving to not be a problem? Or proving not to be a problem? I don't know. A blighted rock golem on the first stage? What? I didn't even know that was possible. That shouldn't be possible. Why is this possible? I mean, I have glass, so whatever, but that shouldn't be a thing that can happen. I seriously don't think that should be a thing that can happen. What on earth? Okay. Get some epidemic spreading in there just to clear out the little guys that are around where I don't want them to be. Because I want to go back for that big chest. Like, I'm going to risk it. This is a bad idea and I'm doing it. Nice crit there. It's gonna take me a while to clear out all these golems, but that's fine. I'm just being nuts again, just like I did last time. This is undoubtedly going to be the root of my downfall, but what can you do? And by what can you do, I mean you can just not be an idiot like me. That's it. Just don't be an idiot. I'll buy this because it's a passive, and I can. Alright. Big chest. Hello. Alright, beating Embryo. Use items have a chance to double effect. I don't actually think that does anything with the Explorer's Key. Unless it's just like maybe doubles the area in which it's active or something. Get Epidemic in here and kill all these fools. Get dead. I do appreciate how golems can't one-shot me right now. Because under most circumstances, when you have glass active, golems can one-shot you in the first stage. But getting that early Guardian's Heart is just, it's doing wonders right now. Okay. Oh dang. Thought I could make that little fall right there. That's fine though. That epidemic should kill all those things. Get some caustic sludge, summon these dudes, they're all gonna die. Play the shrine a bit. Alright. Almost done around here. 7 minutes. Probably not good. Like, I'm dead. I'm gonna die. But it's fun. Good, good. It's spread to the rest of them. So, got a bunch of items. Med kit, or I guess health kit. I can never remember exactly what it's called. I don't really pay attention. I just kind of instinctively call it med kit. Heals me for 10 after getting hit. It's 4 seconds after I get hit, I think. Guardian's Heart, I've already shown you what that does. It's obvious. It's the shield that's keeping me alive right now. I'm gonna go look for more loot, because I'm already behind. Oh, jeez. Cool. So yeah, that's that. Spike Strip. When I get hit, I drop Spike Strip that slows enemies. Bustling Fungus. Stop moving for 2 seconds. Heal rapidly. Head Stomper has already told you about that, and you've seen it in action. Grit specs. There's not much more to say on that matter. Sprouting Egg heals me rapidly if I don't take damage for 7 seconds, so I've got a lot of healing options right now, which is really nice. Although it's glass, so I don't have much health to heal, but whatever. Rapid Mitosis. Chance for use items to double effect. I'm honestly not sure if that does anything with Explorer's Key. Barbed Wire does damage in an area around me. You can see the barbed wire right there, actually. I went ahead and used the Explorer's Key, because why not? It's early on in the level. What? Did this not drop anything? What's the deal here? Oh, it's just another sprouting egg. It just fell. That's fine. So barbed wire's damage actually stacks with glass, so it's remarkably powerful with glass active. Then I also have a goat hoof, which is speed upgrade, life savings, which gives me gold over time, and then a fire shield. If I take enough damage in one hit, I explode. Does a bunch of damage. Everything in this game just does a bunch of damage. Hey, look at that. That is a blighted child. That is two blighted children, and I am not dead. Why am I not dead? Oh, God. Two questions. Why am I not dead? And again, why am I not dead? Holy crap. Okay. This is scary. I'm glad I found the teleporter so quickly, though. In theory, I can get out of this place soon. Oh, I wasn't expecting to move forward. I forgot that's what Akrid's basic attack does. Epidemic, however, is just destroying everything, which is fine. Oh, nice. Spread epidemic to 25 enemies. Speak of the devil. Or rather, speak of the caustic demon. That too. I mean, look at this. The magic of Akrid's epidemic is that it kind of makes a situation where the game plays itself, which it can be boring sometimes, but depending on how you get the game to play itself, it can either be incredibly boring or incredibly amazing. With Epidemic, I think it's amazing. I just love watching these enemies inexplicably die, basically. It's completely ridiculous and a lot of fun. Akrid is just such a great character. There's a shrine up here. I might as well play that since I can. Get more Epidemic. Didn't actually do much that time. How disappointing. Alright, I should really try not to stand still too much. I can actually kind of let barbed wire do a lot of my work right now. On that note, I actually really hope I get more barbed wires, because getting more barbed wires stacks the damage and the size, which is pretty swell. Okay, the one issue I have right now is that all of these children can basically, like, two or three hit me. Which is scary. But we survived. I'll try and get out of here quick as I can, more or less. Quick as I feel like, in other words. Another bustling fungus. I'll play this once more. And nothing. How about this other shrine? Got something good for me? Probably not. Doesn't hurt to check, though, given how much money I currently have. Alright. Not particularly useful. Again, not particularly useful. They're both decent items, but I don't have any drones, so I don't need the drone repair kit. And as cool as Snow Globe is, I think I would actually... I just realized I inadvertently made a pun. I'm sorry. As cool as Snow Globe is... Nice, more barbed wire, just what I wanted. But as cool as it is, I'd rather have the Explorer's Key, because it's just going to be useful overall. So yeah, look at that. Barbed wire, just destroying. Healing drones are more valuable than they would otherwise be with a glass because you have so little health. Oh, sunken tombs. This is what I wanted last time. Man. Darn. I think this is the layout with Akrid. I mean, I can never tell, honestly. It's always like a 50% chance. It totally is. So this is how you unlock Akrid. Go to this stage, go to this layout, inspect this box, Akrid. Insert Akrid here, basically. Now, the only reason I'm killing Akrid is because Akrid is worth a lot of money. Enough money to make the time worth my effort. Yeah, look at that. Already got enough to play each of these shrines twice, probably. Yeah, more than enough. And then I completely missed the epidemic. Good plan. Alright, so Will-O-The-Wisp, chance to explode enemies when they die. It's really useful for crowd control. And the Harvester's Scythe... Oh, there's the teleporter. Harvester's Scythe crits heal me, which is pretty sweet, given that I got a crit chance increase item earlier. Alright, this is exclusively an imp stage, because Kin is active. So it could potentially be frightening, but... not really. I believe that is the second foreign fruit I've seen this episode, or rather this run. and like what, the fourth I've seen in the last today, in the last hour and a half, something crazy like that. Getting a fire shield is actually really nice given the setup I've got right now, because taking even one hit is enough to trigger the explosion, and that explosion basically keeps me safe. It knocks enemies away and does a lot of damage. Couple that with a little bit of added stun that I get, and barbed wire starts kicking in, being wonderful. Anyway, so 56 leaf clover. Elite enemies have a chance to drop items, which is pretty swell. Everything is swell. This is going okay. Taking the extra time on the first stage, I don't necessarily know if it was worth it or not, given that I didn't actually have much of a payout. But it was interesting. I'll just say it was interesting and leave it at that. Okay, so Thallium, chance to slow enemies on hit and do damage over time, just stacking the extra DOT that Akrid already has. You had to teleport away from that epidemic, didn't you? You meanie face. Or you could just teleport onto the caustic sludge, that's fine too. Given that I have to go all the way around again if I came back here, I might as well just kill everything that spawns up here. Teleporter timer is almost down anyway. And there we go. And these are the only enemies left anyway. Sweet. Alright. Looking for loot. There is this one chest right here, the one big chest. In this particular layout, it's always right there, it's always discounted, so go for it. It's also kind of a tricky jump. Anyway, prison shackles, slow enemies on hit. Which is okay. Prison shackles and spike strips, it's almost like there's a police theme going on there. Probably isn't too much more left on the level other than those two shrines up there. Oh no, there's a chest. Alright. This went very well. I'd be leaving this stage far sooner than I did last time. By last time, I mean I didn't leave at all. Okay, more 56 leaf clover. Does exactly what you think, given what its effect already is. You know, making elites have a chance to drop items, it just increases the chance for them to drop items. And that's gonna be all that I can do here, so whatever. These buttons. Okay. Did I look over here to the left? I don't know if I did. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I just played those shrines a little prematurely. Nah, we're good. Alright, let's get out of here. Go on to the next stage. If it's Magma Barracks and it's the layout where I can unlock the artifact, I'm gonna be just irritated. Not angry, just annoyed. Oh no, it's Hive Cluster. Okay. That's cool. Should be just fine. Hive Cluster is generally considered to be easier than Magma Barracks, although the Kin effect gave me greater wisps, which I'm not excited about that. These things are a pain, especially in groups. Okay. For now, I'm going to explore the middle and upper areas and see if I can find any teleporters. Fortunately, not very many of these things can actually spawn at any time, so I'm pretty okay with that. There we go. And I can still destroy them quite rapidly anyway. That is I believe it's called a medical drone? Hold on. I wasn't exactly paying attention when I walked over it there. Yeah, it's a medical drone. Medical drones are basically insane amounts of healing, so I am super interested in that. Snake Eyes, failing a shrine, does the thing. Failing a shrine does the thing, yes, that is so descriptive, truly. Gives me a chance, increases my crit chance, basically. Not basically, that's what it does. It's only when I fail shrines, though, and it's only I think it applies to all shrines except imp shrines. I'm pretty sure those ones are exempt from that, from the effect. So, like, if I play this once more, ah, dang, there goes my crit chance. Another Bustling Fungus is nice, though. The extra healing is appreciated. Appreciable might be a better term. It's hard to say. I'm content to just chill up here right now, because... Oh, or maybe I'm not. Because thankfully, these things, just like the children on the previous stage, or stage prior to this one anyway, these guys can't actually jump up. So, yeah, I'm fine with just, quote, ledge camping. I got smashed on the brain, I'm telling you. I've been playing Project M so much with my friends, and I know I haven't had any uploads for it recently, and by recently I mean in the last, like, 2 or 3 months. Unfortunately, there isn't actually much I can do about that. We haven't exactly had very much luck with recording devices, software, anything. It's all been just consistently failing us at some point, in some way. So... yeah, oops. I fell. It's okay, though. Oh boy. Do I want to go buy that medical drone is my next big question. I have a lot of big questions in this game, because you gotta make a lot of really intense decisions. The medical drone would certainly keep me alive extremely well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look around for loot. I'm going to check around the bottom here. Hopefully I find something good or something worthwhile. I hope I do. If I don't, that's okay. I'll just buy the medical drone and, you know, carry on. Go to the final level. Hope that I don't get some outrageous kin enemy. Archer bugs, I'd be fine with archer bugs. It would be irritating, to say the least, given that they could probably kill me in like 2 seconds. But I'd be fine with it. And... boop. There we go. I remembered that I needed to unlock that thing, so I figured I might as well just do it. I still don't know why that bloated survivor has 2 archer bugs in it. Ooh, nice. Double jump. Yes. Nope. I was going to play that once more if it meant I could still buy the medical drone, but it didn't, so I can't. And also, I have a 2 stack for the snake eyes, which is a fairly significant critical hit chance increase. Coupled with Harvester's Scythe means that I will be healing quite a bit. That is such a weird-looking drone. I like it. Alright. On to the last stage. Making some really good time. Temple of the Elders. Alright, this is not the guaranteed golden chest spawn. But I can totally just play the hell out of this thing right here. Oh, or it could just explode. That works too. And we got Temple Guardians. Got Temple Guardians for the kin effect. That's fine. Temple Guardians are actually probably the ideal one to get here. Claymen would have been awful. You know, I just remembered I have the Explorer's Key. I should probably actually use that at some point. Infusion! Finally! Yes, good. Alright, so Infusion can potentially break your game if you have Glass active. Because, you know, permanent health increase every time you kill an enemy. It gives you a lot of health. Okay, I'm gonna be cheesy here. Actually, I'm just gonna get this immediately. There is such a thing as pause buffering when you have those things going through their rotations, because you can just kind of... every item that appears, you can just pause and then take it. It's the one you want, anyway. But I saw the Rusty Jetpack immediately, which increases jump height and decreases gravity. So, it's very useful coupled with a double jump. Again, given my insane amounts of healing, I can afford to play the hell out of these percentage health shrines. It's risky, but it could potentially have wonderful payouts. Look how quickly I just heal it all back. It's kind of ridiculous, actually. Hey, nice, a monster log. Hey! Got enough to unlock the Huntress! Sweet. I'm happy to see that. Down to 1% health and immediately back to full. That is nuts. I like this. Okay. I'm gonna do that cheap pause buffering again. Should have gotten the Guardian's Heart. Ooh, I want this. Yes! So, killing an enemy throws out a bunch of spirit bolts that seek out other enemies and then kill their faces, and then they all die, and it's fun. Spirit bolts. There they go. See all those little purple particle thingies? That's what they are. I am totally okay with farming this level for a while because these enemies are really, really easy to kill. And, it's all in the name of infusion, really. Also, this really is super risky, but I'm doing it. Especially because these Temple Guardians have such a low attack speed that it doesn't really concern me too much. I can just quickly move out of the way if I need to. Alright, that's fine. Got a life savings there at the end. I don't think that one epidemic is going to kill those things over there, sadly. And it didn't. Eventually, all those ceremonial dagger bolts will probably kill them, though. If they actually, you know, don't despawn by that point. It's possible, I don't know. I am taking a little bit longer than I should. I don't think I care, because I'm pretty freaking powerful. It's not necessarily that I'm super powerful right now, it's that I can't really die. I heal far too rapidly, unless I take a single huge hit that completely— oh, and I get increased passive health regen just entirely. Unless I get hit by like a single insanely huge thing, I'm not gonna die. It's just not possible. So I'm content to take all the time I need. Keep looking through the temple here. Ooh, another percent health shrine. That's fine. I am unopposed. More pause buffering in case I see something I really want. Or, you know what, given that there's all these things just spawning in here, I'm just gonna let it go. It gave me a ukulele. That's cool. I'm down. A couple of sticky bombs. Cool. So ukulele is a chance to electrocute enemies on hit. Now, when I say on hit, the initial hit from Epidemic does actually count towards those kinds of chances. So in large crowds, Akrid can just melt them with a single ukulele. It's beautiful. I mean, Akrid can already melt crowds, just like by default, given its basic skills. Oop, my headphones just did something dumb. I think. Well, maybe this is just the part in the song that I never really heard. No. I think my headphones did something stupid. Hey, increased crit chance! Okay, and a smart shopper. So now killed enemies drop a whole bunch of extra money. Oh no, it wasn't my headphones. It's just me being paranoid because my headphones do dumb things sometimes. It's not the headphones, it's the cord I use to connect them to my computer. Those just do some dumb— It's just marginally faulty. Anyway, I think this is probably a good time to trigger the teleporter. So I don't want to get too many of these guardians spawning around here. Especially because there isn't really all that much left to buy, so like, whatever. Oh boy. Now the one thing that can really threatens me right now is elites like those that spawn missiles or do other things like electrocute. Those things have a chance to do some real damage. Basically, even though I'm powerful, I gotta stay on my guard. And even though Temple Guardians are really no big deal, I gotta stay on my guard. Pay attention, try not to die, you know, the works. How this game typically goes. Man, if only all my Isaac runs could be this swell. But unfortunately, there's no such thing as glass in Isaac. I wish there was. I really do wish there was. That is an item that I would take at any time, basically. But But then again, this run is only successful because I have incredible amounts of healing power. Without that, I would be dead so many times over. Just kinda letting barbed wire do a bunch of work right now. I do have to pay attention to when these guys shoot though, because as you noticed a moment ago, they can hit me, and my healing drones can die. As tragic as that would be. Hey, nice! Bank 20,000 gold, unlock the golden gun. I didn't even notice I had banked 20,000 gold, so... That's cool. I am totally... Okay, I don't remember if there was anything else left in the stage to buy. There might have been, like, an attack drone or something, so I'm just gonna go back and look. Down there, by the way, is one of the artifacts. You get it by jumping off the right side of the stage. And no, I am not kidding. You literally jump off the right side of the stage. Then there's some, like, wonky platforming section, which is kind of difficult to do without at least a second jump. If not that, then you need at least one speed upgrade. I feel like, yeah, see, there's an attack drone here. I didn't get this thing earlier. I can't make that jump. So, drones damage, plural, I don't even know how I'd properly word that, also scales with glass. So, basically the drones themselves can take out enemies and I don't even have to try. Look at that. Not necessarily melting like butter, but melting like pancakes. Or congealed syrup. I have pancakes on the brain because my dad made pancakes for us this morning. Because he's nice like that. And when I say this morning, I really mean when I woke up at 12:30 in the afternoon. I don't mean for that to happen, it just does. My sleep schedule is terrible. Does that actually hit from there? Dang, I thought it would. Alright, well, you're dead. That's right. So, do I want to try looping, or do I want to just go straight for the boss? I want to go straight to the Risk of Rain? I think I actually want to try looping. I'm sketchy on whether or not I'm going to succeed. But I want to give it a whirl. Make sure I hit the right button here. Now, the first couple stages when you're looping are apparently the most difficult parts in the game, and I have no reason to think that is incorrect, because believe me, it can be very challenging sometimes. I can totally make that. Sweet. There's this one little chest up here, and I still have Explorer's Key, so whatever. Back up. Backup is cool. I don't want it. Actually, I think all that talk about how the first stage in looping is the most difficult is kind of negated by the Kin artifact. If I get lucky enough to have sand crabs, I basically have no problems. I mean, sure, they're mostly elites and they can all do a lot of damage. But at the same time, not really. Also, another barbed wire is cool. I am totally down. Ooh, shit, a Blighted Sand Crab. Okay. Blighted Sand Crab, however, can destroy me, so I gotta be more cautious. How I perform for the next few minutes is gonna make or break this entire run. In other words, what I mean by that is I can't really afford to make any mistakes at all. Alright, but Ceremonial Dagger plus Pandemic plus Caustic Sludge is a godlike combination when you have glass active. Actually, it's just really good in general. Oh shit, there's the Blight. Hello, Blight. How nice to see you. How you doing today? That is certainly an item. Not an item I want to take, however. Did my attack drone die? I think my attack drone died and I didn't notice. Well, dang. Yeah, the game is kind of playing itself right now, and believe me, I'm totally down with this. Okay, get some Pandemic in there. Or Epidemic, sorry. Pandemic is the upgraded version, which requires a specific red tier item. I think it's called the Lost Scepter? Something like that. I think what that does is every time the epidemic spreads, it heals me for some amount. Forget exactly how much. Okay, I'm taking a little bit of damage. That explosion was undoubtedly due to the fire shield I've got. But yeah, this is going pretty well. I think I'm safe to loop for a little bit longer. And of course, I'm getting a lot more health because infusion. Because, you know, that's just what happens. There's still a blight somewhere on the stage, though. First war banner, woo! I forgot to mention the teddy bear, tough times. 14% damage intake reduction, so it's just extra armor. It's called First Aid Kit. I should really remember that. I really should. And I think that might actually be it for the loot on this stage. So I guess all I can really do now is just kinda go. There's the blight. There went the blight. There was a blight there at some point. Maybe. It's hard to say. Okay, there's at least a shrine here. Might as well play this then. Sprouting egg. Watch thing that I can't use. Because it's cool, but I'd rather have... Actually... It's... sure. I don't really need the Explorer's Key now, honestly. I mean, I've got... So many enemies spawn, and I have at least one Smart Shopper, so I'm pretty much fine for now. So the Unstable Watch does exactly what you'd expect. It stops time for an amount of time. I'm gonna down some water, so I'm gonna pause here. Pause. Oh, man. My voice isn't starting to hurt, but my throat certainly is. So I should probably take a break from recording soon, actually eat some dinner, that might be a good plan. That is like the luckiest teleporter spawn. And we got jellyfish, okay. Alright, jellyfish is scary. Jellyfish is actually really scary. Because they're not affected by knockback or anything, and they can just completely destroy me. Also, I guess I still had the attack drone and just didn't see it or something. But with the attack drone and ceremonial dagger, I should be okay. It should be fine. Gasoline. Oh, the artifact I couldn't remember what it was, is sacrifice, I think. Makes it so you don't get any chests or anything like that, but enemies can drop items. Look at that total carnage. Oh my gosh. Did you see that? Do you see that? That is ridiculous. I love this game. Oh, nice, another jump. It's not really another double jump at this point, it's just another jump. And of course, epidemic still kills everything. So that's a second healing drone. The extra healing, by no means do I need it anymore. Really? At all? It's just cool, I guess. And... This is a passive, so I'll take it. Or rather, it's an item with a passive effect. Yeah, the game is playing itself at this point. I don't even need to try. Just killing, like, a couple jellyfish in the beginning made this doable. That totally does destroy it. Cool. I didn't know head stompers could destroy that thing. Insert epidemic here. Oh, come on. The spirit bolts from ceremonial dagger just stopped. I don't understand why. And at this point, I have so much health that nothing's really gonna kill me at all. So, I think I'm safe to keep looping. This is fun. This is a lot of fun. It's been a while since I had such a broken run of brokenness in this game. I had one I did a while ago, it was off camera, like the last time I played, I think it was, I wasn't recording. But that particular one was really interesting for me, in that I was playing on Drizzle difficulty, and I just wanted to see how broken I could break everything. So I had naturally glass, command, I was playing as chef, and I think I went for like a full 2 hours straight before I think actually the game, it wasn't that the game crashed, it was that my computer crashed because the power just went out in my house for a little bit. It was just long enough that it caused everything to crash, to quit. It died. Did I get a mortar tube? Oh, I have 2 mortar tubes. Didn't even notice. And by I didn't even notice, I mean completely forgot. I'm gonna play the shrine. Can you get me something cool? It didn't get me anything cool. But a little bit more speed never hurts. I can lay out a lot more caustic sludge with it. Yeah, see? Faster you are, the more you can lay out. Hello, friends. I see you are attempting to follow me closely. Would you like some help with that? I am not Clippy. Or Clippit, or whatever the hell that thing is called. I'm just gonna activate that thing and let it go. I don't even care what I get at this point. Another ukulele, that's fine. Oh, one of my healing drones died. And there's Akrid. I summoned him in so we could play. I almost made a really dumb joke. I apologize in spirit for the thing that you didn't have to hear, and you should be grateful that you didn't have to hear it because it was dumb. Oh shoot, my other healing drone is- or no, my attack drone is dead. Well, dang. That's fine. Okay, I should stop farming these guys and actually go find the teleporter. Get myself out of here. Because as doable as this is, oh damn it, a blight, really? As doable as this all is, I'm still probably gonna end up dying somehow. Oh, the blight's right there. How nice to see you. Another war banner, okay. You know what? I'm gonna stop time, and I'm gonna run. For a minute there, I thought I had the double defect from rapid mitosis that I got really early on. What? 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 How's the teleporter not over there? What the heck? I mean, sure, I guess. Nope. I really don't want this medical drone to die. Where the hell is the teleporter seriously down here? Seriously? Oh my gosh. Disposable missile launcher is actually pretty powerful with glass. But no. Instead, I'm gonna do something that's probably gonna be considered cheating. Can I actually? No, I can't. Okay. Well, in that case, I'll just chill on these ropes. Or whatever these things are. Plant things. Seaweed. What even is this stuff? They're not chains. They're not ropes. Looks like they're some sort of growth. It's hard to say, though. So anyway, Epidemic is up there just destroying everything, and of course Ceremonial Dagger's kicking in as well. If I ever need to trigger it again, I could just do that. Get them a little bit closer so it can spread, and there we go. Bob's your uncle, I believe the old phrase is. And everything dies. If I just stop time right here, Epidemic still spreads. That is super sweet. I like it. Did I actually get the double defect? I think I did. I mean, I'm down. Thankfully, there haven't been any missile elites spawning around here, because if there were, I would have to be a lot more... what's the term that I can't think of? A lot more aware of my position, like my placement relative to enemies and stuff. I'd have to be moving around a lot more, in other words. I can't think of the term. What is that word that I just can't remember? Damn it. Prudent. I'd have to be more prudent about my positioning, my placement, where I am on these ropes specifically. Get more epidemics in there. This is fun. I don't even have to try. I do have to try. I'm just in a particular place where trying is useful but not necessary, basically. Oh, that didn't actually hit. I was hoping it would. That is the wrong button. That's fine. Okay, this blight is it's a little bit of a concern, but then it died, so whatever. Oh, hello, other blight. Oh shit, you killed my medical drone, asshole. That's okay. I can just kind of dance around this thing. It is damaging me, though. There we go. And I want the medical drone back because this thing is just wonderful. It really is. I mean, it, with so much health, it's not as necessary as it was before, but I don't know where the run would be without it. I'd be dead so many times over. Especially from playing all those percentage-based health shrines in the last level. The first last level. Okay, energy cell. It's pretty obvious what that does. That was 56 leaf clover kicking in. Killing an elite, dropping items, you know, the works. Orbanus effect, giving me a little bit of a speed buff there. I guess for now, I'm just gonna go back around, kill the last things, and, there we go. We're good. Everything's fine. Oh, right, there's a shrine down here. I forgot about that. Waste all the money! Give me something. Give me four... Is that the third foreign fruit I've seen this run? Oh my gosh. I'll take the laser drone, because I can. Like, why not? And I guess I'll go buy back the other drones that I lost, even though they're not exactly necessary at this point. But they would be nice to have. Look at all them rainbow full sand crabs. Look at me not giving a shit. Oh, there's another blight and oh, that's the original blight. Okay. That's fine. Buy back drones. Alright, that should be a lot of damage to this thing. Get a little bit more in there, for sure. Alright. I don't think I checked off to the left to see if there were any chests or anything, so I'm gonna do that. Or maybe I did, and again, just completely forgot. Yeah, I forgot. That's fine. I can totally make it up here, that's pretty swell. And I remembered there was this shrine up here, so I guess I'll just play this thing then. Bitterroot, 8% upgrade to health. 8% more health, in other words. Not exactly super useful, but then again, that's quite a bit when I already had, what, 700 some odd health. Raised to 823 max, which is cool. I am gonna keep looping, because I'm nuts. Does it? Because I'm nuts. Let's see here. Magma bear. Oh, damn it. This is the layout that I wanted with the. No, and I have no way to hit the buttons with Acrid, I don't think. The only way to hit these buttons with Acrid, I think, is to have the cremator shoot them. Which is obnoxiously difficult. But you know what? That's probably not going to work. Since I'm here, I'm going to make it my goal to get that artifact, and I have evolved Lemurians. Oh wait, cremators can't spawn because of kin. I wonder if the Lemurians can trigger the buttons. Probably not. Darn. Can't say I'm not disappointed by this. Well, here. That doesn't work. I don't think that's going to work. My timing was off, that's fine. Nah, that's not gonna work. Get over here, button! Darn it. That is certainly very disappointing. I have a golden opportunity here and I can't take it, because I'm not the right character. Well, don't worry, next run we'll be playing as the Huntress. I'll be playing as the Huntress. I don't know why I keep saying we. It's just me in here. There's no one else. Next time I'll be playing as the Huntress, and the Huntress can absolutely hit these buttons, so I'll do what I can. However much that may be. Playing the shrine. Ignoring the shrine. Here's the teleporter. Another prison shackle. I don't actually know what that does. Maybe that just slows enemies even more. Ooh, monster tooth, nice. Killing an enemy heals me for 10 health. Basically, even more crazy amounts of healing. And I get friggin' snow globe. Why am I red? Oh, that must be the particle, the effect from infusion. Okay. I am unopposed. Alright, the great thing about Evolve Lemurians is that I don't have to hang around in one place and kill them if they keep spawning, because they're just going to come to me eventually anyway. Okay, were there any other items down here? I don't think there were. No. This is a pretty loot-barren level, I must say. And by loot-barren, I mean there's no chests, there's just shrines. Which is fine. I'll just play the shrines a bunch, I guess. What else am I going to do? Yo, can you Lemurians hit these buttons? Hit the buttons. Somebody hit the button. That's not the button. They can't. Okay. I was just watching for the one that passed through it. Just hoping. Just hoping. Spike strip. Just what I wanted. Not really. Harvester's Scythe. Okay, another one of those. That's fine. Stay alive. Don't tell me what to do. Another gasoline. I don't think I mentioned I got one earlier. Killing enemies sets the ground on fire. It's actually pretty powerful. At least it can be. Again, glass. Glass will make it powerful. And another goat hoof for more speed. How many do I even have right now? I don't see it. Three. I've got three goat hooves. Welcome to Easiness Central. I'm gonna go through the last level again. This could be bad. I could get something that'll destroy me. I could get Claymen. Claymen would annihilate me. Oh nope, got Elder Lemurians. That's fine. In the interest of time and my patience, this is gonna be- I'm not gonna loop any more than this. I've done enough looping. I mean, I've proven that I can survive a super long amount of time right now. So I'm content to leave after this. Currently, I am also just letting barbed wire kill these things. Ugh. These headphones squeeze my head too hard sometimes. It's very sad. I want to buy this thing before I head off to the right. Because, I mean, just, why not, really? It's just a little bit of a time saver. Don't know why I'm so into saving time right now. I've taken all the time in the world for this run. You gonna spread? I was hopeful. There we go. I get Tesla Coil. Sweet. So now I shock nearby enemies. Kinda like, it's just like the ukulele, except that it's me, and it's considerably more frequent of an effect than just when I hit enemies there's a chance. It's whenever I am, there's a chance. You see what I mean. Elder Lemurians should not be a problem, honestly. They're going to be even easier than Temple Guardians because they can only hit me nearby. And I think they were also nerfed so that they can't jump up ledges, kind of like parents and children. I'm going to pause buffer this because I'm a cheapskate. That is a behemoth. I want that. Yes. Hitting enemies now. Dealing damage to enemies. And by dealing damage, I mean, oh wow, that's convenient. I mean, initial hit damage, so like from Pandemic, it's only the initial hits. When it spreads, now explodes. Functionally, a 20% damage increase. Also, there's explosions. Like, seriously? It's explosions. Can you get any better than spike strips? I mean, explosions. Can you get any better than explosions? That is an explorer's key. I don't think I really need that. Okay, another Guardian's Heart. That's pretty fine with me. Just linearly increases the size of the shield from 60 to 120. Like, yeah. I don't know why I feel such a need to just talk about the game and the items that I'm getting. I mean, they're all useful, but I'd like to assume that my audience knows what this stuff is. And that I guess what I'm saying most of the time is kind of redundant. But at the same time, it gives me something to talk about, because when you get to this point, when you get to this point in a run, when you're looping and you're super powerful and there's nothing left to talk about, it's just like, what else can you say? You're having fun. This is a great run. You're looping and it's nuts. That's it. There's really nothing left to comment on, other than the items I'm getting. I suppose I could comment on how I'm just totally wrecking all their faces, but I've done that a few times. Back up. Very powerful with glass. Everything is powerful with glass. Didn't I already say that? Pretty sure I did, because it's true. That is a golden chest. Golden chests are guaranteed to have a red item in them, so I guess I'm going to be saving for a golden chest. Am I going to have enough for it? Maybe, I'm not actually sure. It's possible. I hope I do, that's for sure. I'm just going to sit here and spam my ranged attacks. There we go. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to end up with enough for it. Oh, sad. That's unfortunate. It looks like it's going to be pretty close, but it's probably not going to happen. Okay, last... There's one more. No, it's just you. Yeah, unless this one Elder Lemurian gives me enough for it. No, no. Dang. That's disappointing, I must say. But at least I can afford the other things up here. Like this. I'm just gonna let that go. I get ATG Missile Mark 2, alright. Hitting an enemy has a chance to fire 3 missiles that do a bunch of damage. Pretty sweet. Again, every time I say hitting an enemy, it refers to just like the initial hit from Pandemic, and then also, you know, these things. I don't think Caustic Sludge is applicable though. And I'm just gonna go on to the final level. I feel I've already proven I'm gonna win. I have more health than I probably should at this point in the game. So I might as well just go. Here's the obligatory for anyone who Let's Plays this. This is where you unlock Handy. I don't think that's obligatory, but I see every LP'er saying it, so I might as well just point it out. I always do. I mean, if I get to this point in the game, I point out that it's a thing, because it's there. It's easy to mention. Not like it takes any extra time or energy or effort. And I have Young Vagrants for my one enemy, or one, one enemy. There was a lot of good stuff in there, but I'm totally okay with another Guardian's Heart. Also, I did see that one golden chest, which means that there's the one golden chest up there, and then there's the one that always spawns right down there, right below me right now. Which is, it's interesting getting there. I'm probably gonna go for it as soon as I have enough money. And in fact, Young Vagrants, I'm gonna take my time and just explore and see what I can find. Hopefully, I can get 4 key cards. Because that is an achievement that I haven't yet gotten in this game. I mean, I have gotten it, just not in this particular save file since I last, got a new computer and stuff that removes most of my old data other than the achievements that I have gotten. Sorry, getting the 4 key cards would just unlock something for me. That's all it would do. Okay, you know what? I don't want to deal with all this shit. You could all just casually die, that'd be nice. Yeah, get wrecked. And this would be a good time for me to move, because all of those things can still kill me. So Rusty Blade, chance to bleed enemies on hit. That's nice. Crowbar, so now I do extra damage to healthier enemies, or enemies with health above a certain threshold. Some percentage threshold, I'm not even sure what it is, honestly. First aid kit. So I've got 4 of those now. I can totally make it up here, sweet. There's this nifty little broken window you can go through right here to get into this place without using a keycard. I like going that way if I can help it, because it's just, it's convenient, really. I must say, all of this avoiding these things is kind of getting on my nerves. Good thing I can do that! So another infusion. Increases the health upgrade that I get to 1.5 health per kill, as opposed to 1. And then it stacks linearly for 0.5 beyond that. What else did I just get? Oh, bundle of fireworks! Happiest mask, oh my god, I don't even think that works with Young Vagrants. Bundle of fireworks, when I open containers or active, or like buy drones or something, or... Nice, another double jump. 1, 2, 3, yeah. Or anything like that, throws out some fireworks. Those actually are pretty powerful, honestly. So, yeah. Happiest mask, when I kill an enemy, it would spawn a ghost that, you know, fights for me, except that these enemies don't actually spawn ghosts when you kill them, so it does nothing. I mean, it's certainly wonderful. It's a great thing to add to my arsenal, but it's not helpful. The only use it's going to be is when I'm fighting Providence, when I kill the little Temple Guardian things that he spawns. When I do that, then it will be relevant. Yep, there goes the fireworks. I can get a lot of fireworks down here. Fireworks, 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 fireworks. Every firework you see in there does as much damage as a single ATG missile Mark I. The only reason that they're so, that it's white tiers, because, you know, there's only so many of these containers all over the place. There's nothing else down there. Darn. I was really hoping for golden canisters or something. Those golden containers contain key cards. And I really do want to try and get all 4 key cards if I can. Which, I believe there's like a low chance that they're a random drop from enemies if you don't have the golden containers around. Now I saw this little guy over here. Friend, come with me. Attack drone Mark II, number 3, it looks like. Can't count. That is probably the wackiest place I've ever seen a chest spawn in this level. Seriously. Maybe not exactly the wackiest, but okay, sweet. There's a golden container. Golden canister or whatever. Alright, and I have enough to get that one golden chest, so I'm gonna go for it. Specifically the one that always spawns. The second one, I will farm a bit for that, and then I'll get it. And hopefully it'll have something wonderful. So long as it's not Dio's friend, I'm fine. Yes! I have enough jumping power to get all the way up there. That is excellent, I must say. So, that golden chest totally looks like it's- oh my god, another double jump. Totally looks like it's completely hidden. There's a hidden ladder right there. It took me so long to find out that was a thing, like, I never knew. Okay, so permafrost, chance to freeze enemies on hit, is actually pretty swell. I don't actually know if it works with Young Vagrants or not. Can find out shortly, I guess, with this pandemic here. Key card, nice. And it doesn't look like it works with these guys, which is a shame, but they are technically, like, sort of bosses. I think mini-boss is probably a more accurate description of what Young Vagrants, you know, truly are. I can make it all the way up here? Oh my god. Yo, what is this? I didn't know I could go up here. What is this thing? Is that just a thing? Is that all that is? That is an interesting looking thing. I wonder what it is exactly. Maybe it's just a broken part to this, you know, broken ship. Wouldn't surprise me. Okay, if you could all just die. I'm getting real tired of your shit here, Vagrants. That is another key card, however. So that brings me to 3, it looks like. One more and I'll have everything I want. This is a passive, so I'm gonna take it. Another freaking first aid kick, because I totally needed that. Yeah, I don't care. Give me something good. Another infusion. Cool, I guess. Not super mega. I don't need more infusions. I have enough health as is. It's fine, though. I mean, take it. No reason not to. It's free. Sort of. I had to pay money for it. But that doesn't mean it's not free. You guys know what I mean, right? You know what I mean. This golden chest contains the old lopper, which is actually really nice. So I always land critical hits versus low health enemies now. I'm totally down with that. That's powerful. So many crits. Somehow I knew that would hit. Alright, I gotta farm a little bit more. That's another ATG missile mark too, ain't it? Yeah, it totally is. So now the chance to fire that missile is higher than it was before. It's greater than it was. I'm gonna go ahead and activate that. Is that another golden chest? Oh my god, that is another golden chest. What the hell? That's not supposed to be a thing that can happen. Except that it totally happened. It's happened. It's there. Three golden chests on one stage. What is this ridiculousness? And by that, I mean this ridiculousness is amazing. And please continue. I want more. So I still need the one last key card, which means I'm going to keep farming until I get it. I mean, I can't not at this point. I'm too invested. Okay, there's the ATG Missile Mark 1 I mentioned a moment ago. Four key cards! Hell yes! Sweet! I am happy with that. And there is actually, what the hell? Oh, another energy cell. Okay. There is actually one more gate down there that I have to open, but I'm not going to do it just yet. I want to keep farming. This is pretty chill, all things considered. I think it's kind of obligatory that I say that at least once per episode. Once per video. Except for the songs. The songs don't necessarily need all things considered, because the songs are the things that are being considered. That made sense in my mind. I am starting to get the hiccups for some reason, like the burp hiccups. This is awkward. Very, very awkward. Alright, I'm gonna open everything. I'm gonna buy everything. I don't need a minefield, however. Yeah, I guess I'll just keep going. I mean, there's nothing else to say. I want to buy everything. I want to buy that last golden chest. I want to open all of these armory lockers. I gotta do all these things. I have an opportunity to do everything in the Risk of Rain ship for once, so I think I'm gonna take that opportunity. I'd rather have this. Increased passive health regen. By no means do I really need it anymore. But that's okay. Wish I could get more of these vagrants spawning at any given time. Oh, they're called gun chests. I was mistaken. I thought they were armories. Or like armor chests or something. They are gun chests. There's a healing drone right there. I'll take it. I mean, why not? Repair the healing drone. Unless that was one of mine and it died and I didn't notice, which would not in any way surprise me. It's kind of a thing that I wouldn't notice happening. Alright. Oh, that was empty. Lame. It's fine, though. A few more vagrants and I'll have this last gun chest and then I can go down and open all the other things and do all the other stuff and just be generally obsessive. Not necessarily obsessive, just, I don't know, determined, I guess? Driven? Motivated? There we go. And it contains another mortar tube, that's fine. Unfortunately, one of Acrid's best capabilities, which is the incredible amount of crowd control it's got, doesn't exactly apply when you're fighting Providence. So I'm going to have to rely a lot more on, like, one-on-one close combat sort of stuff. It's marginally annoying, but what can you do? Caustic sludge, neurotoxin, bite, pandemic. Acrid is just, you know, just a formula for destroying things. Another happiest mask. If only I could actually use that. But alas, I cannot, because vagrants are not affected by that, and by that I mean they can't be ghosts. Look at all these little medical things. I'm opening all these because there's a chance that they'll all have something good. They could have, like, attack speed buffs or things like that. If only I could actually open them. Did I get them all? No, I missed one. There we go. They've got, like, medical bay themed things. This is a good item. That is a very good item, but I'm not taking it. I would rather have the unstable watch. The speed decrease, I feel like my damage output is enough that I don't need that item back there, which increases my attack speed and damage for, you know, whatever the duration is. I don't know exactly how long. I think 8 seconds or something like that. I would rather have the speed, the time buff, so to speak. Time slowing effect of the unstable watch. What are you doing down here? That chest right there gives me a random use item when I activate it, and it's supposed to go up into the cabin there, where Providence is found, where the final boss is, but it didn't go up there for some reason. It's not the first time I've seen that happen. It's just some kind of peculiar glitch, really. Just a little bug. Doesn't really change much about this run, though. I think Tesla coils stack for damage. I think they do. I'm not 100% certain. Anyway, that was an interesting run, but it's not over yet. I still gotta beat Providence. Gotta beat the final boss. So let's do this. Let's go win. And just ignore all the little young vagrants, because they're all gonna die. And when I say die, I mean they're just gonna disappear. Disappear. Still gonna attack me, though. That was the sound of someone coughing outside my room. Goodness. Okay, so I'm just gonna do this. I do appreciate how Providence's shield isn't as intensely powerful as it used to be. Okay. I do have to be cautious here because I do want these drones to live. Yeah, look at that. It's already taken out one of my healing drones. It was probably the one that was almost dead, though, so no big loss, really. No. Get back down here. I need you back on the caustic sludge so you can keep taking damage from it. Ah, yes. Gilded worms. Jeez. Clam down, friends. The healing station right there does actually heal my drones if I need it. Which, it's... I'm just gonna take it. Deal 5,000 damage in one shot. Cool. Killed one of the worms, too. Yeah, the worms are segmented enemies, so the damage they deal is intense. Pop that and do a whole bunch of damage to Providence right off the bat, that's fine. I was saving the unstable watch for when Providence spawns in his little shadow buddy, because that thing can really do a number on me. So I was just trying to be cautious. Also, I just noticed my medical drone. Oop, medical drone is in trouble. Pandemic. So those things down there are now ghosts. They'll fight for me, because happiest mask. The two happiest masks that I have. Okay. Looks like I've taken out the shadow, and we win! I'm gonna get my drones back. Friends, join me in our victorious conquest of the asshole known as Providence. Yeah! We win? And so it left with a new hunger to be left alone. The ending lines in this game are so cheesy. They're fun. They're fitting, but they're just cheesy. Yeah. So that's a victory right there. I can't actually just skip the credits anymore. I gotta speed through them. Do I hold enter or space? It looks like I can just hold any button. So that was a lot of fun. It was kind of inevitable that I'd win given that I had glass active, and Kin certainly made things easier, but that was really just the luck of the draw based on the enemies that I got. So overall, it's not always easy to win a run like that, but I won. So yeah, cool. That's gonna do it for today. Thank you all for watching. If you watched the whole thing, I applaud you. That was a long one. And yeah, as always, don't forget to subscribe if you want. And I'm Ollie's Audi, I suppose. See y'all in the next video.